February 27th. Today was okay. I'm going to try to use prompts for these videos from now on. So, as far as my body goes, still got the choking feeling. Still got the tension all up in here. I did a sauna today because I felt okay. So a big thing is I woke up at like 2 and my throat was extremely scratchy and I got worried that I got sick. So I used the immunocidin and then I used a sauna and, you know, took precautions so I don't get sick. And it just reminded me that I need to reinforce that I need to really just remain super cautious and protect myself from this while the world is getting better and vaccines are being, you know, parsed out and, you know, the pandemic is, COVID is being mitigated. I need to hunker down and protect my borders as best as I can and make decisions that don't put me in jeopardy of getting it, because I am vulnerable and I am compromised. So that's a big thing I need to remind myself constantly of. What am I proud of? I want to start taking time every day to acknowledge and recognize when I do things that are right. Because if I take the time to criticize myself and criticize and just be very, just scrutinize everything I'm doing, I need to acknowledge the good stuff. So, because I feel like a lot of times we don't get acknowledged or recognized for the good things we do, and it makes it less of a, even if they're little things, and it makes it less likely that we do them when it comes to those decisions. So I'm going to recognize today that I am proud that I did the sauna and stuck through it 40 minutes and sweated out some shit. And I'm proud that I didn't do as well as I wanted, but I at least took time to palace a word of the day or symbol of the day, being all kind of synonyms of constructive, useful, and that kind of stuff, because I've been wanting to do that. I am proud that I studied a lot today and walked, and I am proud that I made a decision on a movie quickly, even though it was very, it's very little or innocuous, or not innocuous, just not important, trivial. But I hate, like, trying to figure out what I'm going to watch, and it takes me forever, and I kind of just decided quickly, and it felt good. I'm proud that I am taking the time to teach my mom about accelerated learning and using symbols and memory palaces to memorize stuff. I'm proud of the videos that I'm posting, and I'm proud that I'm finally giving it to the world. So yeah, that's good. Where I can improve today in body, I feel like, okay, so I didn't do the Theracane, and I want to do that consistently. So I think from now on it's going to be my post breakfast ritual, doing it right after. And another way I can improve is the same thing with the so as far as like studying the first things that I learned in to the day, like the Daily Stoic that I memorized in the morning, of the ones that I studied, I did not study that enough. And I'll get to it in a second, but I need to reinforce that better. So after my breakfast, that's kind of when I want to start to take action better, rather than just, I don't know, doing nothing. So I can eat, then I can use a Theracane a little bit. And then study, and then get to my, and then clean up my dishes, and so to speak. And then it'll be vegetable chopping time, which is going to pose a problem this week, but in general. And yeah, I feel like I need to have a specific time of day that I do the memorizing of the body stuff, because I want to incorporate that next month. So, yeah. Need to find a spot for that and write that down. That's what I'm using this video for, so I might as well leverage it. I'm going to highlight it in my to-do list. Time day. Order. That's kind of what I'm doing right now, and that's another thing I'm proud of, is that I'm incorporating this prompt, so I can better find order and constantly reorganize and improve my day-to-day functioning. Find more useful practices to leverage. Yeah. And that's good. Daily Stoic today was cultivating indifference while others grow passion. The quote is, of all the things that are, some are good, others are bad, yet others are indifferent. The good are virtues and those that share in them. The bad are the vices and those that indulge in them. And the indifferent lie in between and include wealth, health, life, death, pleasure, and pain. And it goes on to say, and this is by Epictetus, and it goes on to say that how powerful it is to have to conduct yourself while others are. See, I didn't do a good job of this one. Of all the things that are, some are good, others bad, and yet others indifferent. The good are virtues, and all that share in them. Good are, and those, I think I said, and all that share in them. Okay. Imagine the power you'd have in your life. So, imagine the power that you would have if, of all things that people are fearful of and get angry about and are greedy. Okay, so green money on one side, emotions on the other, envious, jealous, greedy. So right now, this symbol is a chimney. That's my loci for where I am, my palace. And on top of the chimney, like at the apex, the peak of it, is the gauntlet, infinity gauntlet power. And on the front side, facing the road, is the emotions. Yeah, and then on the other side is going to be green jello with money in it, jealousy, greed, and then above that, on the same sides, is going to be peace, a peace sign, so calm, tranquility. Windex, clarity, clear-headedness, objective. Okay, and then Seneca is the next station, and it's on top of the roof. So Seneca had a lot of stuff, like material wealth, but he recognized that it could be gone with any moment and wasn't too attached to it. So rather than desiring for more or fearing that he would lose it, he was indifferent. He was kind of in between. It's not about avoidance or shunning, but rather not giving the possible outcome more power or preference than it is appropriate. That's one I didn't do a good job with today, to be honest, but I'll do better tomorrow. And that's where I want to leave it, because it's already really long.